Consider this parallel flow concentric heat exchanger, where here we have hot oil coming in and it's cooled by water that jackets it. And given the information below, we want to find how long does the tube have to be in order to perform the necessary cooling. Before we start, we're going to make a couple of assumptions. So the first assumption we make is that there is negligible heat loss to the surroundings. And what that means is that all the heat that's being transferred is transferred between the two fluids. The second assumption that we make is that that wall in between the two fluids is thin. And what that implies is that there is no conductive heat resistance between the two fluids. So let's start with our governing equation. And our equation says that the heat transfer rate is equal to the overall heat transfer coefficient times the wetted surface area times our delta T log mean. And we use a delta T log mean where delta T is the difference between the hot temperature and the cold temperature at some point. However, this delta T varies along the length of the heat exchanger, so we use a log mean temperature. So now we're going to rewrite it in terms of what we're looking for, or L. And we'll start with this area, which is going to equal pi times D times L. And let's go back and look at our picture to see which diameter we're going to use. And since the heat exchange is occurring here, we're going to use that inside diameter, or 30 millimeters. So now we'll rewrite this such that L is equal to our heat transfer rate divided by the overall heat transfer coefficient times pi times the diameter times our log mean temperature. So let's put together a plan. The first thing we're going to do is we're going to calculate our heat transfer rate, Q dot, using that Q dot equals the mass flow rate of one of the fluids times its heat capacity times the change in temperature from the start to the end of the heat exchanger. Once we do that, we're going to calculate our overall heat transfer coefficient using our given convective heat transfer coefficients. And remember that there's no conduction, so we won't have a conductive heat transfer coefficient as part of that overall one. Then we're going to calculate our delta T log mean from the given temperatures. And finally, once we have all that information, we can calculate what our L is. Let's start with Q, and we're given the mass flow rate and the heat capacity of the oil, as well as the delta T. So we're going to use those to calculate Q. So our Q dot is going to equal 0.15 kilograms per second times 2,131 joules per kilogram degree Celsius times 100 degrees minus 60 degrees, and our Q dot, therefore, is going to equal 12,786 watts. So now we have to calculate our U. So our U is going to equal 1 over the convective heat transfer coefficient of the oil plus 1 over the convective heat transfer coefficient of the water raised to the negative 1. And so when we put in our values for that, our heat transfer coefficients are given here and here. So this is equal to 38.1 watts per meter squared degrees C. Now we need to calculate our delta T log mean. And this is equal to delta T1 minus delta T2 divided by the natural log of delta T1 divided by delta T2. And so what is this delta T1 or T2? Well, the subscripts 1 and 2 correspond to the different ends of the heat exchanger. So 1 is the difference in temperature at the entrance, and 2 is the difference in temperature at the exit. Recalling that our delta T is the difference between the hot and the cold temperature, let's go back to our picture once again, and you'll note that in a parallel flow heat exchanger, our delta T1 is just the difference between the temperature of the oil coming in and the temperature of the water coming in. So here, our delta T1 is going to equal 100 degrees C minus 25 degrees C, which is 75 degrees C. We do the same thing for our delta T2, which is the difference in the temperatures exiting the heat exchanger, and that's going to equal 10 degrees C. Let's find our delta T log mean. So our delta T log mean is delta T1 minus delta T2 divided by the natural log of delta T1 divided by delta T2. And when we calculate this, we find that this delta T log mean is 32.2 degrees C. And finally, we're ready to calculate the length of the heat exchanger. So that's going to equal the heat transfer rate, Q dot, and that's going to be divided by our overall heat transfer coefficient times pi times our diameter, which is 0.03 meters, times our delta T log mean, and therefore the length of our heat exchanger is going to be 110.6 meters.